Hello, my name is Meagan Hurley, and I'm a legal fellow with the Georgia Innocence Project, and you're here today watching GIP from A to Z, where we break down topics and terms related to wrongful conviction work. Today, the letter we're on is P, and P is for post-conviction. So I want to explain to you guys a little bit about what it means for a case to be considered post-conviction. Post-conviction is a term of art in the legal community that we use to refer to the procedural posture that a criminal case moves into after a person has been convicted and their direct appeals have been exhausted. In Georgia, examples of a post-conviction proceeding might be an extraordinary motion for new trial or a writ of habeas corpus. So as you may be familiar with from TV and popular media, when a person is charged with a crime and their case moves through the criminal legal system, typically it goes to either a trial or a plea, after which a defendant may be convicted. After that person has been convicted, they are entitled to a direct appeal process by which one or more appellate courts generally will take a look at the record below from the trial court and determine if there are any legal issues that would warrant overturning the conviction. If a person's conviction is affirmed on direct appeal, meaning that their appeal has been denied, their case then moves into a post-conviction posture. Now, this post-conviction designation is significant for a variety of reasons. First and foremost, a person no longer enjoys a right to counsel once they are in the post-conviction posture. So we're all familiar that you have a constitutional Sixth Amendment right to effective assistance of counsel, and that applies through trial and the direct appeal process. But once a conviction has been affirmed on appeal, if a person doesn't have money to go out and pay a lawyer to represent them, then they generally must represent themselves, and that's called pro se, which we might cover in a later video. This complicates things pretty severely. So as you can imagine, most post-conviction litigants are in fact in prison, which significantly hampers their ability to go out and meaningfully investigate their cases on their own. Many or most of them do not have legal training like a lawyer would. So it's really hard for them to get their cases back into court. And with actually innocent post-conviction litigants in particular, often the very thing, the only thing, that can get these clients' cases back into court is some discovery of new evidence indicating their innocence. So again, if a person is left to represent themselves pro se, it is very, very difficult, if not impossible, for them to be able to succeed in their endeavors. And this is the posture at which GIP comes into play and begins reviewing cases, investigating them, and oftentimes taking on representation of actually innocent men and women. That wraps up our video on P for post-conviction. And tune in for more of these. Again, this is GIP from A to Z, where we break down topics and terms related to wrongful conviction work. Thank you.
Hey y'all, this is Christian Stegall here, Community Engagement Manager and Development Specialist here at the Georgia Innocence Project. I want to thank you for tuning in and watching this video. Please don't forget, if you like what you saw, hit the like button and subscribe so we can keep making more videos and content like this for you. And as always, don't forget to check out GeorgiaInnocenceProject.org. Again, that's GeorgiaInnocenceProject.org. So you can stay up to date on everything that's happening at GIP. We're also on Instagram and on Facebook as well. Find us there, and we'd love to have you. All right, guys, take care, and thanks for watching.